Welcome to Section 1 of the Teacher's Training DVD, An Introduction to Court.
My understanding is it was first conceived by Dr. Edward de Bono in the 1970s, where he worked with schools and with children across the whole world, giving them opportunities to work with these tools and techniques.
It's kind of simple to use, it's practical, it's something children can apply, it's something adults can apply. The range of applications is enormous. I mean, it's been used with senior managers in industry to solve major questions, it's been used by politicians, it's been used by school children, it's been used by children of all levels of ability.
It's taught across the world. I know it's taught in Venezuela, Singapore, some of the other Pacific Rim countries. In this country, it's selected by schools as a methodology to teach thinking by some of our schools in England.
Court is a series of thinking lessons. The name CORD stands for Cognitive Research Trust, where they originally developed by myself, and they're thinking lessons to help particularly with perceptual part of thinking.
I think the research is now showing that it's a simple and effective way of helping children to construct their thinking. And children are required to use thinking all the time, whatever they're doing. We say it all the time to children, put your thinking hats on. Think about these issues and problems. Without a structure or a scaffold to help them, then children find that more difficult. This is simple and easy tool for children to use.
The students that I have done court with in schools have come back to me many years later, and I hadn't considered the long-term effects at the time, but now I see it quite clearly that they would automatically use the court in their studies right up to degree level, including one student who got her doctorate, and she said to me that it is how you taught us to think rather than what you taught us that helped me get where I am today.
I started to get involved with court back in 1975 when I was working with children who were suspended from school or considered difficult to teach or impossible to teach. And we were looking for ways to help them find mechanisms to solve problems that didn't involve the use of their fists or other disruptive processes. So we were looking to find tools that they could use, and we explored a number of different possibilities and eventually came across court and started to use that.
In London, England, there's the Hungerford Guidance Centre, which takes youngsters who are too violent to be taught in ordinary schools. They get sent to this centre. Many years ago, the principal, David Lane, started teaching court to these violent youngsters. He's now done a 20-year follow-up and showed the rate of actual criminal conviction for those taught court thinking is less than one-tenth compared to those not taught thinking.
Looked at children who were using these types of techniques and children who were not, and we found that we could map over a 20-year period much lower levels of delinquency in the groups that were had been taught these skills, because they are practical, they do influence the way they manage their lives.
With unemployed youngsters, teaching them court thinking for just 5 hours increased the employment rate 500%. So we're looking at huge effects in other research in schools in England. Teaching thinking, mainly court explicitly, increases the performance in every other subject by between 30 and 100%.
Well, there's been a number of studies in different parts of the world looking at the impact of court, both in industry and in schools, which shows that thinking skills do make a difference to the way children approach issues. It does make a difference to the way children solve problems. It does make a difference to the way they manage their behaviour.
I think that if education systems took on court, I think we wouldn't have the disruption in the classrooms that we have today if court was being used. Edward tells me there's a school in England, and the punishment for these kids is not to go to their thinking lessons, not allowed to go to the thinking lessons. Now, that's pretty powerful stuff.
We've done some research in my own school on observing the way children use the court tools to manage their behaviour. And the research has shown that by giving children a targeted approach like this, it almost enables them to stop before things go wrong, for them to consider what the consequences would be of that behaviour.
To be given strategies to do anything has to be of benefit to anybody. And it is a list of strategies basically to think, and I think it has to be a benefit.
We actually started with a less able group of children in our school several years ago, and what we found was that it gave them a scaffolded approach to the managing their thinking, because it's very direct, it's very segmented, it's about working together, it's about listening, it's about speaking and offering suggestions where ideas are accepted by all. It's non-judgmental, and children therefore have the confidence to have a go.
Those students were suddenly able to turn around and say, I have as good ideas as that other person. They were answering, everybody was answering the questions instead of the more able students.
We've taught CORT, as I said, over several years, and one significant benefit of a child who found it very difficult to actually speak in front of other children. She was part of a session of work with the tools and techniques, and her teacher noticed one day that her hand slowly slid up past her, and she acknowledged the child, and the child offered a suggestion to solving a problem. The child then never stopped speaking after that. So it released her, it gave her a structure to work with, which was tremendous.
Expanding perception is the other way it's very effective. For instance, in writing an essay, I found it very effective for students who usually would maybe write a half a page or something like that and struggle through it. After doing the CORT and applying the CORT tools, they were doing 3-4 pages of excellent material.
There's no question about it. Once people get to know CORT, they can't do without it. Just can't do without it.